The Supreme Court justices are expected to tackle petitions against the Justice Department's travel ban. This comes as the High Tribunal holds its regular en banc session today. Meantime, an Arroyo ally is pushing for the early passage of a bill that gives only the courts the power to impose travel bans. Ina Reformina reports.
The Joint Department of Justice, COMELEC Preliminary Investigation Committee, that is investigating alleged massive cheating in the 2007 midterm elections, denied several motions filed by the respondents during its second and last hearing. These include the motion of former President and now Pampanga Representative Gloria Macapagal Arroyo for the production of election documents allegedly not annexed to the main complaints and for additional time to file her counter-affidavit, and motions of former First Gentleman Jose Miguel Arroyo and former COMELEC Chief Benjamin Abalos for deferment of proceedings as a form of judicial courtesy to the Supreme Court, where they filed separate petitions against a joint probe. With their failure to file counter-affidavits, the panel says it is now ready to resolve the poll fraud raps minus their defense.
As of November 14, the case is submitted for resolution.
This earned the ire of Mr. Arroyo's lawyer.
That is what mystifies me, Your Honors, with all due respect to all of you. Why the haste in terminating the proceedings and seemingly preempting what the court may decide?
We can disagree without being disagreeable. We have better temporal language.
So I hope your conscience will let you sleep at night, Your Honors, after giving respondents only 10 days. And without any recourse, and by mooting any remedies which you might have.
I sleep soundly, but I snore a little louder, sir.
In the end, the committee's decision stands. The cases are now deemed submitted for resolution to determine if there is probable cause to charge respondents in court for the non-bailable offense.
We gave them 10 days now to file their counter-affidavit. And with or without their counter-affidavit, we terminated the proceedings now, submitted for resolution.
We cannot expect any justice from the panel, so in view thereof, and since our appearance here is ad cautelam, I may respectfully request that my presence here be excused, as it will be futile for this representation to continue being with this panel. Thank you, Your Honor. Again, with all due respect.
Mrs. Arroyo's lawyer claims the committee's hands are tied because of an earlier pronouncement from no less than President Aquino himself that cases against the Arroyos will be filed this November. At the lower house, Arroyo ally Representative Edsel Lagman is seeking for the prioritization of his bill that grants only the courts the power to bar citizens from leaving the country. The administration meantime maintains it is not curtailing the rights of the Arroyos and neither is it denying them due process. Justice Secretary Leila De Lima insists government is merely doing its job in the interest of justice. De Lima is also defiant amid calls by the Arroyo camp for her resignation and formal apology following official confirmation the Arroyos are not seeking political asylum in the Dominican Republic.
It was my duty to really verify that. And even if merong ganyang denial, siguro naman kailangan pa rin natin na i-verify mga iba pang mga impormasyon. Walang basehan para mag-resign ako o mag-issue ng apology. Wala naman akong masamang ginawa. Wala naman akong ginawang mali.
Mrs. Arroyo filed a supplemental petition before the Supreme Court on Monday morning, this time raising the issue of the Justice Department's formal denial of her application for an allowed departure order. She is also expected to raise the legality of Monday's poll fraud probe proceedings with the High Court. Meantime, all eyes and ears are directed at the High Court on Tuesday as it resumes its regular en banc sessions. The magistrates are expected to tackle the petitions separately filed by Mr. and Mrs. Arroyo against the DOJ's watchlist orders and may just act on their application for temporary restraining order. The couple may already leave for abroad if they are granted the temporary relief. Ina Reformina, ABS-CBN News.
Now joining us on Hot Copy, House Minority Leader and Albay Representative Edsel Lagman, main author of House Bill 5111, which protects the individual's right to travel. Good day to you, Congressman Edsel Lagman.
Good morning, Karen.
All right. House Bill number 5111 is entitled An Act Upholding the Constitutional Right to Travel and Granting to the Proper Court the Exclusive Jurisdiction to Hold or Issue Whole Departure Orders. Why do we need this when it is clear in the Constitution on our right to travel?
Well, before I answer that, Karen, let me clarify that I filed this bill not as an ally of the former president, but as an ally of the citizens of this republic to protect the right to travel. Now, we need this because this is mandated by the Constitution.
But it is there. I mean, our right to travel is in Section 6.
That is correct. But the Constitution says that as provided by law.
I see.
So we are just following the prescription, the mandate of the Constitution.
Okay.
Because it says there, neither shall the right to travel be impaired except in cases of national security, public order, and public health. Public health as provided by law.
Okay. All right. So you're saying there is no law to support that part of the Constitution?
At the moment, there is no compliance with that Constitution. And executive orders and circulars, like circular number 41 of the Department of Justice, are not sufficient to comply with the prescription of the Constitution.
Uh-uh.
There has to be a statute. There has to be a law.
Actually, circular number 41, I read that in full, says that the Justice Secretary, whoever she or he may be, can issue a whole departure order motu proprio.
Yeah.
And that's a lot of power.
That makes it very unconstitutional because only the proper court can issue the whole departure order. Not even the president, not even the Secretary of Justice. Because if you read completely the provision of the law,
okay,
it also includes the right to abode and the right to change the same within the limits prescribed by law, cannot be impaired except by a lawful order of the court.
Okay. Now, let's talk about Mrs. Arroyo's case specifically. Secretary De Lima had said they are doing this for national interest. There mm-hmm. is a bigger risk if you allow her to have medical treatment abroad. She may not return to the country mm-hmm. to face her cases. Mm-hmm. For me, that is a matter of big concern, especially for the Filipino people. Mm-hmm. So how do you address that risk?
Let me first say that the right to travel is not a matter of humanitarian consideration,
yes,
accommodation.
I agree.
It is not a matter of health condition.
Okay.
It is a question of constitutional right.
Okay.
Absent the limitation of imposed by Congress, by the Constitution, then the right to travel should not be impaired.
Okay.
Now, the rare ailment of the former president is real, but the question on flight or asylum are speculative, more particularly even partisan importuning. So between the two, then I think the right to travel should not be impaired. And it is not national interest that the Constitution provides for. It is national security.
Now, President Aquino had said that he is willing for Mrs. Arroyo's doctors to fly into the country and the government will pay for it. Why not take that offer?
That's not a question of money. That's a question of expense. It's a question of constitutional right. It's a question of choice. The right to travel includes the liberty to choose the destination of the applicant.
Okay, now my question, wouldn't there be any limitations to our rights? Like, for example, we have the right to freedom of speech, but we all know there are limitations to freedom of speech. Mm-hmm. I mean, I know that as a broadcaster, the freedom is not absolute. Isn't there any limitation to that in the Constitution when it comes to, let's say, a specific person who might not come back or the flight risk is really big?
Well, the Constitution prescribes the limitations. And there are only three limitations imposed by the Constitution. Well, in the interest of national security, public order, and public health.
Mm.
And we could not meander outside of the prescription of the Constitution. Otherwise, we will be defying the constitutional mandate.
Okay. Now, the salient features of House Bill number 5111, do you actually expect the president to sign this? I mean, into law? I mean, really?
Well, I don't expect him to.
With your timing.
Well, I don't think I should prejudge the decision of the president. But the salient features are very clear and consistent with the Constitution.
All right.
One is the...
I can read it, then you can tell me.
Okay.
Number one, because your bill is here in front of me. Uh-huh. The exclusive jurisdiction to hold a hold, to issue a hold departure order or allow departure order. Actually, the allow departure order is even questionable in terms of legality. Mm-hmm. Shall be vested exclusively by the court, which shall conduct a hearing after due notice to the parties concerned. Now, what is the system?
Well, the system is now, there are three bodies or personalities who could issue hold departure order.
There are three.
There are three.
Okay. Under, who are they? The court?
The court, the Secretary of Justice, and the President of the Republic.
The President can issue a hold departure order?
Under a circular by the Department of Justice. I think it's circular number 17.
So it's not 41. Iba pa to.
Meron pang inauna dyan.
So technically, Congressman, just to be clear, if President Aquino says, I will issue a hold departure order against Mrs. Arroyo for fear of flight, he can.
He can do that, but not legally.
But there's a circular.
There is a circular, but the Constitution requires the passage of a law, not a mere executive fire.
So why is these circulars all there?
Well, because
it is illegal.
Well, circulars can be legal or illegal, and circulars can be unconstitutional or not. And the constitutionality or unconstitutionality of a circular does not depend on the administration or dispensation when it was issued.
Okay, I'm curious, because circular number 41, which is on the allow departure order, was issued by Secretary Agra, ironically, during GMA's time. Circular number 17 was issued when?
I can't exactly
recall. It has to be GMA's time again.
It's possible.
But isn't this karma on GMA? She issues all these circulars during her time, sir, and look.
See, she was not the one who personally issued. It was issued during her time. But as I've said, there is no estoppel against the question of constitutionality. And the issue on constitutionality or legality does not depend at the time.
Okay.
When the question or controverted circular or law has been issued or enacted.
Okay. Second salient feature of the bill, a watch list order shall not be the basis for holding or preventing the travel of an accused or respondent unless there is an HDO duly issued with finality by the proper court. So my question is, what if it's a suspected drug trafficker who is in the watch list order and yet wala pang kaso strong enough to be filed, but then they know na posibleng mafilan, big time drug trafficker. Ang mangyayari ngayon ito, hindi ma-HDO ang drug trafficker na yon. Pwede makatakas.
Well, the under the proposed law, the Department of Justice or the Bureau of Immigration shall file with the proper court the issuance of a hold departure order based on the prescription of the Constitution.
Pero dapat may case?
Either preliminary investigation or actual case filed in court.
So pwede preliminary investigation under your bill?
That's correct.
Because right now, you can only get a hold departure order from the court when there's an actual case filed.
That's correct.
Okay. All right. Number three, in preparation of a watch list order, the DOJ and Bureau of Immigration shall assure that the accused and respondents are included in the watch list order after a preliminary hearing. Okay, you said that. Number four, the judicial issuance of a hold departure order shall be based solely on the three grounds said in the Constitution. Explain that.
Well, the Constitution prescribes three grounds when the right to travel can be impaired.
Okay.
One, it involves...
If you're a risk?
It's if the projected travel would involve national security.
Yeah.
Or public order.
Okay.
Or public health.
Okay.
Absent any of these grounds, then the right to travel cannot be impaired or abridged. So we are just following the mandate of the Constitution when we propose the enactment of this bill.
Okay. I'm curious, have you visited Mrs. Arroyo recently?
Well, I think during the break I did, and she was frail.
Where, in St. Luke's?
No, no.
In her home?
At her residence.
Okay.
And she was really losing weight, and I think she was not in a state of health. And we fully know, Karen, that the former president exhausted all Filipino expertise before deciding to consult foreign doctors and go abroad for treatment. Okay. If she really wanted to
escape,
then at the first opportunity, even before the first operation at St. Luke's, she should have already manifested her desire to travel. Mm. But she did not.
And they were saying that she left the country during Aquino's time. She left the country 5 times and came back.
That's correct.
Okay, That's
correct. In other words, there are no indications of flight. Any statement of the administration that she is going to escape from liability or have asylum in another country is merely speculative.
Okay.
And it cannot surpass the present situation of the president, which is real.
All right, and now, could there be a failure somehow in GMA's camp that they were not able to explain this to the public well? I mean, I'm just curious. Like, they chose so many countries, the countries keep changing. There was one request before that there was even a conference that she was going to.
Well, that was long before
okay. The
operations, I suppose. But the change in the number, places of destination, is the choice of the applicant, because the doctors may be available in one place, not in another place.
Okay.
Or there could be a mistake in the identification of the country where the doctor is located. But let me just say that it is so arbitrary on the part of the administration to say that she can only go to countries where we have
an extradition treaty,
because out of the 193 countries in the world, we have only extradition treaties with 7 countries.
Okay.
And doctors can be practicing in countries where we do not have any extradition treaties. What are the 7? The United States, Canada, Australia, Switzerland, Indonesia, Micronesia, South Korea, and there's an 8. That's the Hong Kong territory.
We have an extradition treaty with Switzerland?
Yes.
That is shocking, huh?
Well,
really?
Because
in Switzerland?
That is supposed to be the depository of hidden wealth.
Okay, but then did the president write Switzerland in the list because there's stem cell therapy in Switzerland, and if we have an extradition treaty there?
I'm not aware whether Switzerland had been included.
Okay.
But it all depends on the choice of a physician or doctor of the applicant.
Okay.
So that cannot be constricted or limited. And it is so arbitrary to say you can only go to a country where we have an extradition treaty.
Now, do you think circular number 41 is being used for political harassment now?
It's obvious.
Is this political harassment?
It's obvious. And it is part of that predetermined prosecution and persecution of officials of the previous administration, because they have already determined that they're going to file cases by November, and the former first couple will be incarcerated by December. So these are prejudgment. That's why there is good reason to challenge the jurisdiction of this joint panel.
Now, what is the difference between what the Aquino administration is doing now and what GMA did to ERAP?
Well, there's a whale of a difference. In the case of ERAP, he was allowed to go to Hong Kong to have his knee surgery, despite the fact of the pendency of a plunder case before the Sandigan Bayan. In this particular case, there is no charge or complaint or information before the proper tribunal, judicial tribunal.
Doon nga ako nagulat eh. Sa limang plunder case na final, wala pang isa na kaso na. Wala pa.
Wala. Wala. Nothing has been filed before the Sandigan Bayan or before the proper
court.
Court.
Yeah. So they're all pending for preliminary investigation at the DOJ.
That's correct.
Why is that?
Well, they have another perception of what is right or wrong, you know. And I think it is just consistent with their selective justice.
Okay.
Because as I would see it, this joint COMELEC DOJ panel is a resurrection of the Truth Commission, which has been debunked and declared unconstitutional by the Supreme Court. Because the primary reason here is to prosecute the officials of the previous administration, more particularly the Arroyos.
Okay. All right. We'll be right back with Congressman Edsel Agman. We'll be reading questions for you from Facebook and Twitter. Please tweet your questions, Hot Copy. We'll be right back.